Official name: Slovak Republic. Capital city: Bratislava.
Currency: Euro.
Official language: Slovak.
Population: 5,500,000.
Slovak is a Western Slavic language, very closely related to Czech and relatively close to the Polish and the languages of the former Yugoslavia.
Nationalities: 85% Slovak, 10% Hungarian, 3% Roma, and smaller nationalities include Czechs, Ruthenians, Ukrainians, Germans, and Poles.
It is a republic with parliamentary democracy.
Head of government, prime minister, generally the leader of the largest party in parliament.
Head of state, president elected once every 5 years.
Hi! Hello!
Let us introduce Slovakia.
Now we are in touch with our online friend Jan Kosec from Bratislava. Jan, tell us about the flag of Slovakia and where it is situated, please.
Добрый день, vážená Галина Анатольевна, а дети. Volám sa Jan Kosec, bývam v Bratislave, hlavnom meste Slovenskej republiky. A chcel by som vám trochu porozprávať o Slovenskej republike, hlavnom meste republiky, štátnych symboloch a o mene, ktoré je teraz na Slovensku. A v minulom bola. Takže Slovenská republika je mladý zvrchovaný štát, ktorá sa utvorila 1. januára 1993 pokojným rozdelením Československej federácie. 1. januára 1993 začala oslavovať tzv. Svoje narodeniny, svoje utvorenie. V Slovenskej republike býva zhruba 5,500,000 ľudí. Hlavné mesto Slovenskej republiky, Bratislava, sa rozprestiera po oboch brehoch Dunaja.
Na severe Slovenská republika hraničí s Poľskou republikou, tak ukážem vám tuškou. Na západe hraničí s Českou republikou a Rakúskom, na juhu hraničí s Maďarskom a na východe s Ukrajinou. S Ukrajinou je najkratšia hranica 98,5 kilometrov. Čo sa týka štátnych symbolov? Štátne symboly Slovenskej republiky sú štátny znak, štátna vlajka, štátna pečať a hymna. Tu je štátna vlajka, štátny znak a štátna pečať a slovenská hymna. Tu ja vám v konci aj zaspievam. Aspoň skúsim. Čo sa týka meny. Od roku 1993 na Slovensku chodili tzv. Slovenské koruny. Vyzerali tak. Tak. A potom od roku 2009 začali sa využívať eura. Eura. Tak, z jednej strany a z druhej strany vám ukážem. Eura. Hej. A ešte taký štátny symbol vám ukážem. Slovenská vlajka môže vyzerať tak a môže vyzerať aj tak. To sú u nás dva druhy. No, do skorého stretnutia. Majte sa dobre a učte sa.
Line writes in the
center of Europe, Slovakia is a delight to explore. The scenery is amazing. You can see lots of interesting historic sites and cultural places. Because of its strategic location, the country was ruled by Mongols and Hungarians, Ottomans and Czechs, and only in 1993 Slovakia became an independent state. The country has a lot of traditions and customs. We want you to know more about this beautiful country, and we take you on excursion to 10 wonderful places to visit in Slovakia.
The place number 10 is Orava Castle.
I'm going to tell you somewhat about it. It looks impressive. It is one of the most beautiful castles in the whole Slovakia. It was built in the 13th century and has been never conquered. And it's easy to see. There are many walls, gates and defenses. It stands on rocky hilltop in green forest and the Orava River runs below it.
The place number 9 is
Vekolinek is one of the only remaining folk villages in Central Europe. It is full of impressive architecture with traditional houses. It is a very quaint and charming place to visit. This tiny village is situated in the forest, covered hills and fields with mountains seen in the distance.
The place number 8 is Barrio.
Badajoz is a wonderful historic center for you to explore. It's hard to imagine a more picturesque place. The life in the small town revolves around its beautiful marketplace just as it did centuries ago. There are some interesting wooden churches in it.
The place number 7 is the Slovak Paradise National Park.
The Slovak Paradise National Park is the breathtakingly beautiful park of the country to explore. Deep canyons, valleys and rivers cut through the endless forests. You can find in it sparkling waterfalls. At times you need to cross thin bridges and climb up the ledges. The hike is very challenging, but to enjoy the beauty makes it worth the effort.
The place number 6 is Košice.
Košice is the second largest city in Slovakia. You can visit fantastic bars, restaurants, body shops, art galleries, museums and cities. You can admire the fantastic sights and architecture in this spectacular old town. There are a lot of churches, palaces and a cathedral here to see.
The place number 5 is Levoča.
Land with beautiful old town houses, Levoča's historic main square is spectacular. With glorious Gothic and 15th century town hall line at its heart, Levoča is full of incredible historic sites and cultural landmarks.
The place number 4 is Spiš Castle.
The town of Spiske Podgradia is famous for the ruins of Spiš Castle, which occupies a large territory. It is the largest castle complex in Central Europe.
The place number 3 is Barsta Štiavnica.
Banská Štiavnica is a fascinating city to explore. Rich minerals were found in the ground around the city. The former mining town has a magnificent historic center with a lot of lovely churches, palaces and museums.
The place number 2 is Karpatras.
High Tatras is the tallest mountain in the country. There are a lot of great slopes to ski down in winter. High Tatras is a national symbol.
The place number 1 is Bratislava.
Bratislava is the capital and the largest city in Slovakia. It is in the west of the country. The heart of the city is magnificent hilltop castle. The river Danube divides the city into two parts. Bratislava is a very beautiful city. Many years ago, it was a capital of a powerful Hungarian kingdom. There are galleries, museums, cinemas, theaters, and churches in the city. Bratislava never gets old, and if you want a change of scenery, then both Vienna and Budapest nearby.
Sweet dishes. Slovak apple pie is very popular in the world and we are going to try to bake it.
First, wash, peel and cut the apples. Toss them with a little flour, sugar, vanilla and ground cinnamon.
To make apple pie, start with the crust. If you're making a homemade crust, you can make the dough a day or two ahead and keep the dough discs chilled in the refrigerator.
To make a dough, you need sour cream, butter, egg, sugar and flour, and mix all these products.
Then we are rolling one of the discs. When it becomes thin, put it on the oven tray. Slovak cuisine is unique. They eat pork, poultry, cabbage, potatoes, cheese from cows and sheep, onions and garlic.
Rice doesn't grow in Slovakia, but they like it very much. They eat fruits such as apples, plums, apricots, peaches and cherries.
So girls, may I help you? Because it is very difficult. Now we are putting this dough in the oven tray. Yes. So, and we remove the paper very carefully. Right. Yes. Yes, right. So, it's very nice.
Then we are putting apple slices on it.
Mm-hmm. All right. So, may I help you? So let's put all these slices. Right. Yes, it's very nice, girls.
Then we are rolling the second disc and cover the apple slices with it and join the edges.
Pork, beef and chicken are the three most popular meats in Slovakia. Lamb, duck and goose are not so popular.
And if you are going to travel to Slovakia, you might walk a lot, exploring old castles or ski down the hills. So you will need a lot of energy and it means that you will want to eat properly.
So girls, let me help you, please. Right, so and as Polina has already said, we put it so all the apple slices, so in this way, yes, so it's very nice, look at it, and we're going to join the edges, so yes, so you may put your fingers in a flower, Nastya, right, and this way, you see?
Now I can put it in oven and bake.
puts homemade cream on the top of it. There is nothing better of sliced warm Slovak apple pie. Do you agree?
Yes, we agree.
Mmm, looks tasty. I think the piece of the Slovak apple pie is excellent.
I would like apple pie.
This project turned out to be interesting. We've learned a lot of amazing things about Slovakia.
Thank you for watching us.